So next, part 5, oppression in the year 1765 to 1835. But the British continued to oppress Indians. In 1818, they had passed Regulation 3. Under it, an Indian could be jailed without trial in a court. So, they did not stop to suppress Indians. They continued to dominate the Indians. So, moreover, they passed a bill in the year 1888. What kind of bill? It had passed, they had passed, the British had passed in the Parliament a Regulation 3. Regulation 3. What this Regulation 3 will do? Once the Regulation 3 become an act, become a law, you can arrest anyone without any investigation, without any trial in the court. If they don't like somebody, they can immediately arrest that particular person. That is what the Regulation Act 3 would do. Here they have passed a bill, Regulation 3, in the year 1888. They did not stop to suppress the Indians. They continued actually, okay. So, but the British continued to oppress Indians. In 1818, they had passed Regulation 3. Under it, an Indian could be jailed without trial in a court. All the time, British officers in India drew big salaries and also made fortunes in private business. So they were enjoying their life. British people, the white people, they enjoyed, they got big salaries, and also they business were going fine in India. So all the time, British officers in India drew big salaries and also made fortune in private business. By 1829, British was exporting British goods worth 7 crore rupees to India. They export some goods in the year 1829. By 1829, Britain was exporting British goods worth 7 crore rupees to India from England. Okay, they were exporting things from England to India. The British prospered on the company's loot. Loot means they are not doing the things proper manner, but they are looting. Okay. Governor General Bentinck reported back home. During that time, the Governor General of India, the Bentinck, reported back home. The bones of cotton weavers are bleaching the plains of India. Bleaching the plains of India. What is the meaning of bleaching? Discoloring. Okay. The bones of cotton weavers are bleaching the plains of India. Who reported this? Bentinck to back home. Next part, 6th, dissatisfaction, 1835 to 1856. Education in India, this is very important part. Education in India was in Persian and Sanskrit. Okay, so what was the language in India as far as education is concerned? Persian and Sanskrit. Education in India was in Persian and Sanskrit. In 1835, an Englishman named Macaulay suggested a change. This is very, very important question. Who suggested a change? British man, Englishman named Macaulay suggested a change. Okay. Before, two languages were used in India for education. One is Persian language and another one is Sanskrit. Okay, the Englishman suggested a change in the year 1835. What kind of change the Macaulay suggested? Let us see that. We should teach the natives through the English language. Okay, so because of the miscommunication, they were unable to do what exactly they wanted to do. So Macaulay suggested a change to the British government, East Indian Company. We should teach the natives through the English language. Okay, we should teach the natives through the English language. I agree. Okay, the superior also agreed it. English education produced clerks to whom the British gave petty jobs under them. So English was taught. English was taught to Indians, but the English, because of this English, Indians never got any benefit. Only Indians were used for the petty jobs as clerks. Okay, English education produced clerks to whom the British people, the British gave petty jobs under them. Incidentally, it also produced a new generation of intellectuals. Here, we must educate our brothers and try to improve their material conditions. For that, we must convey our grievances to the British Parliament. Okay, grievances means complaints. Okay, the complaints whatever they had because of the activities of the British people. For that, we must convey our grievances to the British Parliament. See, by 1856, the British had conquered the whole of India. Now see, yellow states, British area. Now, by 1856, the British had conquered the whole of India. They cared little about the needs of Indians. Okay, British cared very little about the needs of Indians. Our kings have become puppets and we have lost our old jobs. This is the talk among Indians. Okay, this is the talk which took place among Indians. Our kings have become puppets and we have lost our old jobs and lands. They are converting our brothers. You only talk, do something to drive them out. Next, the Swats, 1855 to 57. Taxes continued to ruin the peasants. Okay, there were lots of taxes were imposed on Indians. Because of that, Indian peasants were struggling a lot. Okay, taxes continued to ruin the peasants in Bengal. The Santals who had lost their lands, okay, the landlords lost their lands under new land rules. Okay, so frequently they bring out the changes, bringing in the new rules to take away all the land from the local landlords. The Santals who had lost their lands under new land rules became desperate. In 1855, they rose in rebellion and massacred Europeans and their supporters alike. They started to kill the Europeans as well as the people, those who were supporting the Europeans, were killed by the landlords. Discontent was brewing in the East India Company's army too. Okay, East India Company had an army. The discontent, dissatisfaction was brewing. Brewing means developing, okay, continuously developing. Discontent, dissatisfaction was brewing in the East India Company's army too. They had army. Even the army people were not satisfied about the British. The white soldiers gets huge pay. Mansions to live in servants. Okay. So the British white people got more salary, mansions also, but others were not getting anything worthy. This is the talk. While we get a pittance and slow promotion, okay, we are not getting much like the British. Angus asked us to cross the sea, which is against our religion. Okay, there was a superstition, if you cross the sea, you will not be considered as the own religion. So here, the Angus asked us to cross the sea, which is against our religion. Who is the Topi Wala to abolish our age-old customs? Okay, not to cross the sea. This is old age custom. This is our custom. But they ask us to do that. Who are they to ask to do? This is what the concern among the Indian soldiers, East India Company soldiers. Okay, we must drive out the Angles. Sipai Mangal Pandey attacked the adjutant. Okay, adjutant. Sipai Mangal Pandey attacked the adjutant of his regiment and was executed. Mangal Pandey was opposing the East India Company's act. Sipai Mangal Pandey attacked the adjutant of his regiment and was executed. Thousands of other sipais revolted. They were stripped of their uniforms. Okay, thousands of other sipais revolted. They were stripped of their uniforms, humiliated and put in irons. Few Englishmen had cared to understand Indian customs or the people's mind. Okay, some of the people from British taken care to understand Indian customs or the people's mind. Oh, proud Brahmin soldiers! Oh, proud Brahmin soldiers! Do you know that the grease on the bullet you have to bite is made from the fat of cows and pigs? So now the problem is some of the Brahmin soldiers in East India Company, they have to bite before using the bullet. Okay, do you know that the grease on the bullet you have to bite, you have to bite before you use that bullet? What is that in the bullet? Do you know that the grease on the bullet you have to bite is made from the fat of cows and pigs? Okay, the grease on the bullet made from the fat of cows and pigs. Normally we know Brahmins won't eat the fats, okay, the fat of the cows and pigs. Now they have to do that. When they use the bullet, before using that bullet, they have to bite. So now the rebellion starts. See, what the white man has deceived us too. Okay, Brahmins also disappointed even other peoples. Soon chapatis were sent from village to village to tell the people that their emperor would want their services. The communication had happened through chapatis. Chapatis were sent from villages to village to tell the people that their emperor would want their services. Yes, all my village men will be ready. Okay, they agreed. Yes, all my village men will be ready. Similarly, lotus flowers circulated among Indian soldiers. Death to the foreigner. The masses gave all help and shelter to the patriots. 8th one, revolt, 1857. Then there was a violent outbreak at Meerut. violent outbreak started in Meerut. The sepoys marched to Delhi. Long live our Emperor Bahadur Shah. Okay, this is the slogan they made. Okay, they shouted like, long live our Emperor Bahadur Shah. The sepoys marched to Delhi. So, eighth revolt, which took place in the year 1857. Then there was a violent outbreak at Meerut. Okay, violent outbreak started to take place in the year 1857 at Meerut. The sepoys marched to Delhi. Long live our Emperor Bahadur Shah. Okay, they made a slogan and also they marched towards Delhi. The sepoys marched to Delhi like shouting like, long live our Emperor Bahadur Shah. The rebellion spread wider. Many landlords had lost their lands because of the British policies, and they were very much hurt. Okay, they were worried about the British law. Ninth one, the fight for freedom. Many former rulers like Begum Hasrat Mahal of Lucknow were bitter. The white man has taken away my kingdom. Okay, even the former rulers like Begum Hasrat Mahal of Lucknow were bitter. Why? Because the white man has taken away her kingdom. The white man has taken away my kingdom. Popular leaders like Maulvi Ahmadullah of Faizabad told the people, rise brothers, rise, the angles is ruining our land. They joined the upsurge against the foreigner. The people rose everywhere in Bareilly, Kanpur and Allahabad. Azimullah Khan told Tatya too, we should have Beswa Nana Sahib as our leader in this war of independence. Okay, we should have Peshwa Nana Sahib as our leader in this war of independence. 80-year-old Kunwar Singh of Bihar received a bullet in his wrist. Mother Ganga, this is my last offering to you. The patriots pounced upon the British and fought pitched battles all over North India. So Azimullah Khan told Tatya Top, we should have Peshwa Nana Sahib as our leader in this war of independence. The patriots pounced upon the British and fought pitched battles all over North India. 80-year-old Kunwar Singh of Bihar received a bullet in his wrist. Mother Ganga, this is my last offering to you. The man Kunwar Singh said this. This is our freedom movement, okay? From our freedom movement, some extract has been taken and given through this lesson. This lesson has been written by S.D. Sawant. That's what the lesson is all about. Next, in the next video, we will be moving on to the next new lesson. Okay, thank you.